Hello all, welcome to a new video on logic design. In this video, I have explained the concept of 8:1 multiplexer with a typical example. Watch the video till the end and try to understand the tips that have been used to write the binary numbers and also to draw the logic diagram. In my previous video, I have explained the concept of De Morgan's theorem with two typical examples. I have published a few videos on the solutions of the previous year question papers and also a few videos on the selected topics from the course of logic design. The links of all those videos have been given in the description box. So let us move on to the video. First of all, let us see what is a multiplexer or data selectors. Multiplexer is also called data selectors. Multiplexing means sharing. For example, multiplexing or sharing occurs when several peripheral devices share a single transmission line or bus to communicate with a computer. There are different types of multiplexers like 4:1 multiplexer, 16:1 multiplexer, etc. In this video, we are going to learn more about 8:1 MUX. Let us see the block diagram of 8:1 MUX. In general, we can say multiplexer can be represented as n:1, where n is what? The number of inputs. In 8:1 MUX, there are 8 inputs. These are the 8 inputs. That is I0, I1, I2, I3, etc. up to I7. These are the 8 inputs. Now, how many select lines are there in this 8:1 MUX? For that, you have to see the formula 2^m is equal to n. What is the value of n here? It is 8. So 8 can be written as 2^3, that is 2 × 2 × 2, which is equal to 8. So we can write like this, 2^3 is equal to 8, where 2^m is equal to 2^3, therefore m is equal to 3. So there are 3 select lines in this 8:1 MUX, which are there? S0, S1 and S2. These are the 3 select lines and it is having one output Y. Therefore, the name 8:1 MUX, 8 inputs and one output. These are the 8 inputs, I0, I1, etc. up to I7, and Y is the output and it is having 3 select lines. So this is the block diagram of a 8:1 MUX. Now let us write the function table of 8:1 multiplexer. For that, here there are 3 variables, that is 3 select lines, S0, S1 and S2, and one output Y. Since there are 3 variables, there will be 2^3, which is equal to 8 combinations of zeros and ones. Which are the 8 combinations? These 8 combinations can be written in decimal form like this, 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to 7. So these are the 8 inputs. Now you have to write this in binary. For that, we can use this 4-2-1 trick. This 4 is 2^2 and 2 is 2^1 and 1 is 2^0. What is the binary of 0? It is 0, 0, 0. What is the binary of 1? Put a 1 under this S0, that is where you have written the 1, and the remaining bits will be 0. So this is the binary of 1, 0, 0, 1. What is the binary of 2? Put a 1 under this 2 and the remaining bits will be 0. So this is the binary of 2. What is the binary of 3? 2+1 makes 3. Therefore, put 1s under 2 and 1 and the remaining bit will be 0. What is the binary of 4? Put a 1 under 4. The remaining bits are zeros. What is the binary of 5? 4+1 makes 5. Therefore, write a 1 under 4 and 1. The remaining bit will be 0. What is the binary of 6? 4+2 makes 6. Therefore, put 1 under 4 and 2. And the remaining bit will be 0. What is the binary of 7? 4+2+1 makes 7. Therefore, put ones under 4, 2 and 1. So that is the binary of 7. Now we have to write the output for this. What is the output of the first one? 0, 0, 0. That is I0. What is the output of 0, 0, 1? It is I1. What is the output of 0, 1, 0? It is I2. What is the output of 0, 1, 1? It is I3. And what is the output of 1, 0, 0? I4. Then the next I5, I6 and I7. These are the outputs. Now you have to write the logic expression from this function table. So in order to write the logic expression, we have to see how many variables are there. Here S2, S1, S0 and I. 4 variables have to be used in each term. How many terms will be there? 8 terms. That is 0, 1, 2, etc. up to 7. 8 terms will be there in this logic expression. So what is the first term? The first term is wherever you have a 0, you have to write the literal with a bar. S2, you have to write this variable with a bar. That is, for here you have the input as 0. Therefore, you have to write S2 bar. Here also you have another input 0. Corresponding to that, you have the variable here S1. So you have to write it as S1 bar. Here similarly, S0 bar. In the next term, it is S2 bar, S1 bar. Here you have a input 1. Therefore, you have to write this variable as it is, S0. So let us see the first term. First term will be S2 bar, S1 bar, S0 into I0. The output Y is equal to, which are the 4 variables here? S2, S1, S0, I0. In the first case, these are the 4 variables. And here you have to change. Instead of here, the first bit is 0. So you have to write S2 bar, S1 bar, S0 bar into I0. So that is your first term. Second term is S2 bar, S1 bar, S0 into I1 plus third term is S2 bar, S1 and again a 0, S0 bar into I2 plus next term. Next term is S2 bar, S1, S0, S2 bar, S1, S0 into I3. Similarly, we can write the next term and all the other remaining terms. So this is your logic expression. Now we have to draw the logic diagram from this logic expression. So I have written the logic expression from the previous slide. I have just copied that here. Now you have to implement this. That is, we have to draw the logic diagram. For that, the first step is you have to see how many product terms are there. This is in SOP form. This is in sum of the products form, sum of the product form. So you have to check how many product terms are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 product terms are there. So in order to implement the product term, we have to use AND gates. So we have to use 8 AND gates. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 AND gates has been drawn here. 8 AND gates have been drawn here. Now you have to see how many variables are there. S2, S1, S0, S0 bar, S1 bar, S2 bar, I0, I1, I2, I3, I4, etc. up to I7. So these are the variables. So first of all, let us write the 3 select lines S0, S1, S2, 3 variables. And In order to get S2 bar, what you have to do? We have to connect a NOT gate here. If you connect a NOT gate or an inverter with S2, you will get S2 bar. That is, when you give S2 as the input to this NOT gate, you will get S2 bar as the output. Similarly, if you want to take S1 bar, you have to connect a NOT gate over here, so that if you give S1 as the input to this NOT gate, you will get S1 bar as the output. Similarly, for S0 also, we will connect another NOT gate. Now let us see the first set of inputs that has to be given to this AND gate. So that is S2 bar, S1 bar, S0 bar. That is, you have to take a connection from here, this S2 bar, then S1 bar. That means from here, S1 bar, S0 bar, and I0. S2 bar, S1 bar, S0 bar, and I0 is connected to the first AND gate. Now see the next term. This is the next set of inputs, that is S2 bar. S2 bar is already connected to the second AND gate. Then S1 bar. Next literal here is S1 bar. That is the next input. S1 bar. Then S0, S0, and I1. So these are the inputs to the next AND gate. Now to the third AND gate, these are the next set of inputs, that is S2 bar, S1, S0 bar into I2. Then to the fourth AND gate, which are the inputs to the fourth AND gate, it is S2 bar, S1, S0, and I3. Similarly, to the fifth AND gate, these are the inputs. To the sixth AND gates, these are the inputs. Seventh AND gate, and the last term, that is, these are the inputs to the eighth AND gate, S2, S1, S0, and I7. Now we have to connect the output from these AND gates to a OR gate, because this is sum of product terms. So you have already given the inputs to the AND gates. Now you have to connect all these outputs from these AND gates to a OR gate. So this is an OR gate. Connect the output from the first AND gate to this OR gate. Similarly, from the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and eighth AND gates, we have connected to a OR gate, and we get the output Y from this. So this is the logic diagram of your 8:1 multiplexer. Let us do an example based on this. Implement the following logic function using 8:1 multiplexer. F of A, B, C, D equal to summation M 1, 3, 4, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. Now let us write the function table here. So these are the select lines S0, S1, S2. And four variables have been used here, A, B, C, D. Therefore, 2 to the power of 4, 16 combinations of zeros and ones have to be given as the input. So this is the decimal value of those 16 combinations, and we have written the binary of that. You can use this 8421 trick for writing this binary. That is, 8 is 2 to the power of 3, 4 is 2 to the power of 2, and 2 is 2 to the power of 1, 1 is 2 to the power of 0. For example, what is the binary of 8? Put 1 under 8, the remaining bits are 0. What is the binary of 9? 8 plus 1 makes 9, therefore put 1s under 8 and 1, and the remaining bits are 0. What is the binary of 15? 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1 makes 15, therefore put 1 under 8, 4, 2, 1. Now in the next step, you have to write the output. The output is given in the question 1, 3, 4, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Has to be marked as 1 in the output, and the remaining bits as 0. 1, 3, 4, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 has to be marked as 1. Now what is the next step? Next step is we have to make this pairs in order to reduce, because we are using 8:1 multiplexer to implement this. Since there are 16 combinations, we have to pair this. After pairing, here you get this pair as 0, 1. 0, 1 is nothing but this D itself. Therefore, F is equal to D. Here, this 0, 1 is again D. Therefore, F is equal to D. This is just the opposite of D. Here, 0 has been changed to 1. That is, complement of 0, 1 is given here. And complement of 1, 0 is given here. Therefore, F is equal to D bar, complement of D. This one, D. D is 0, 1. D bar is 1, 0. Therefore, we can write F is equal to D bar. Now, here F is equal to 0, 0. Since 0, 0, we can write F is equal to 0. Here also, the output is 0, 0. Therefore, F is taken as 0. And in 0, 1, again, F is taken as D. And here, both the outputs are 1. Therefore, F is equal to 1. Here also, both the outputs, one more 1 was here. F is equal to 1. Now, here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 inputs are there. So, we got the 8 inputs to the multiplexer. 8:1 multiplexer. Which are the 8 inputs? D, D, D bar, 0, 0, D, 1, 1. Now, we have to implement this using the 8:1 multiplexer. Now, we have to draw the logic diagram. So, this is 8:1 multiplexer, which consists of 3 select lines S0, S1, S2 and 8 inputs D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6 and D7 and 1 output F. Now you have to give the input C, B, A to the select lines, and D is connected to D0, D1 and D5. That is, D is given as the input to D0, D1 and D5. And the input to D2 is D bar. Input to D2 is D bar. And 0 has been given as the input to D3 and D4. And 1 has been given as the input to D6 and D7. So this is the logic diagram. Thanks for your time.